Brazen. An imprint of Octopus Publishing Group Limited presents Behind Bars. On Punishment, Prison and Release. Written and read by Lady Unchained. My battles are your battles. Can't you see it? Look into the mirror. I'm you after a prison sentence. Dear justice system, stop failing my people. A voice for the voiceless. Unchained. My nationality does not define me. Yes, I am black, African, black, and I guess that's all you see, but I am so much more. I am Lady Unchained. I am unchained. I defeated the infection that we have grown to call a prison sentence, which, left untreated, can cause your mind to fall apart, haunted by the person you used to be, the person you used to know. Why won't they just let me be me? Why won't they just let me be free? I wasn't born with the hunger to be free. I was born free, Nelson Mandela. And if he could sit down in a prison cell for decades, then who am I to sit down and be defeated by this infectious curse that was created for us to believe that the truth is the lie and the lie is the truth? They used to hang us up in trees for everyone to see, lock us in chains to keep us in check. Now they cast judgment in so-called courts of law and slander our names. I mean, why would our younger generation see themselves as anything different when you teach them the views that you wish still existed? Instead, teach this generation we existed before we were slaves. We wasn't just made to be used and thrown away. Wake up, brothers and sisters. Don't you see we're just reliving the history that we've been taught to believe? I am not strange because of the color of my skin. I am not a criminal or someone you should fear. Crime and Punishment. I was on bail for around 8 months before I went to jail. A lot of people are put on remand. I was lucky. Being on remand means you spend the time before your hearing in prison before going to the magistrate's court. But time spent on remand is later taken off your sentence. You don't get that on bail. In those 8 months, I was going back and forth to court before being sentenced to 2.5 years in prison at Inner London Crown Court near Elephant and Castle. The prison you're allocated to is normally the one closest to the court you're sentenced in. I was sent to HMP Holloway. It was the only prison for women in London, so it felt like everyone got sent there. Road to Victory. I await sentencing, scared and confused, but there's no praying. If God loved me, then I wouldn't be in this mess, that's all I'm saying. You're female with no previous, you'll get off, you've got this, so stop fretting, I hear my friend say. Yet my solicitor's voice rings loud. You're looking at 3 to 5, there's no doubt. So just make sure you pack a bag each time you take that stand. And still, I just can't quite understand. But the judge soon makes it clear. He screams, 2.5, take her away. Take me where? I scream, but there's no sound. The water falls from my eyes, kiss my cheeks. Farewell to me trying to look hard. The life I once knew was no more. Shattered dreams of future plans all just taken in a flash. Dark shadows and angry voices in my head telling me this is the end. This is the end, so just end it. I left a piece of me on that stand. I felt her walk away as I began to walk down them steps. I swear I never even looked back. See, I had to free her from this life that we was about to take. Because she was the me with the dreams and ambitions. She was the me who still had faith in the so-called justice system. She was the me who prayed. She was that 11-year-old girl who sang in Sunday choir. She was the me who wrote songs for Sunday school. She was the me who still cared about life. All she was gonna do was hold me back with her dreams of the life that she once had. Dreams were a thing of the past. Because where I was going, dreams are for the weak. Forget love, I need respect. Because I ain't trying to be no one's chick. My beautiful future, no more. And so I began my life behind bars, broken and defeated. Days were long, nights were longer, weekend bang-ups a lifetime. Pain and tears were only to be felt at night. 11-year-old me, where are you? I need you, where are you? She returned to me in the form of a prayer. Not long now, girl, just stay strong, pray to God and I promise you a better day. All of a sudden, it just made sense. This is the journey that was written for me to take, so I can teach my fellow brothers and sisters that it's not about anger, it's about peace. It's not about power, it's about grace. It's not about hatred, it's about love. These are the lessons I learnt while in prison, so you don't have to go there to learn the same lesson. The choice is yours. I choose to be unchained. Strange fruit. You didn't plant me. You planted the fear of us never being more than just your slaves, your property, your fruit. You cannot pick me up and take a bite of me. I am not yours. No wonder my brothers and sisters are sitting in jail cells thinking that they are fighting back by chaining themselves up, feeding on your hunger whilst their families starve. We pay for the mistakes you make while you just hide behind uniforms and badges that we will never understand. The law is built to protect you. I mean, why else would you cast us away each time we come close to unmasking your disguise? You kill one of our own to remind us who's in control. And like the slaves we are, we turn on each other to please our masters. Our masters who couldn't care less if we were here tomorrow. I am unchained. When you're on bail, you can be given conditions such as curfews, tags, or restrictions on where you can go. When I was on bail, I was told I couldn't go into the area, the club where the fight had happened. When I appeared at the magistrate's court for my hearing, I was warned my case would be allocated to the Crown Court immediately. Magistrates' courts can't send you to prison. My solicitor told me to pack a bag of things I might need in prison each time I came to court. Bail. Being on bail feels like a slow death. Your body is left in limbo as you watch the life you knew fall apart. The smile you had turned into a frown. Love into hate, anger and regret. Bell tells you you're a failure. Future plans crushed. Like taking a test and getting an F. Your words and voice no longer have meaning. The you before bail no longer exists. No one wants to hear your truth. You sit in court and listen to others while they speak about the person you claim to be. Yet, no one wants to hear you say a thing. Solicitors tell you to pack your bag, because each hearing could be your last breath before you're put into the ground. The last time you hear your name out loud, before you're given a number that will become your new identity, the criminal, the convict. Convicted for a crime no one lets you explain. Your ghostly body just watches on as the judge slams the gavel to alert you to the start of your death sentence. No more limbo. This is your casket. This is your funeral. You can't see your family, but you can hear their cries, their screams. Their last sigh becomes your last sound. and only you can hear your screams. You are no longer in limbo. You are no longer on bail. You are dead. A sweatbox is a van that takes you to and from prisons. It's a box. It's tiny. I don't think I'm tall, but now and again, I'd have to turn in the seat to give my legs a break. There are no seat belts, so you slide all over the place. You can see out of the tinted windows, but no one can see in. You can hear everything and everyone in the van. I'm an old soul. I listened to Magic FM growing up. I remember they had Easy, like Sunday Morning, playing on the radio. I started singing along. We passed bars with people sitting outside. I was listening to these songs thinking, this is the last time I'm going to hear any music I know. The drive to North London was quite quick. Suddenly, HMP Holloway was right there, and it hit me. I realised I used to walk past Holloway with my sisters and cousins all the time, and I'd never even noticed it. Sweatbox. A quick pat down and you're pointed to the sweatbox. Climb up the stairs, turn right, and take your seat to watch your life as it falls apart. Watch the normals live their lives as yours comes to an end.
Loved ones. We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.